The siddhis that you're talking of, there are two kinds, riddhis and siddhis. Riddhis are inherent powers of energy within us, and we can deal with them with our energies. We come across problems every day, don't we solve them? We solve them with the energy in us. We have to overcome an obstacle, we jump over it. We have to solve a mathematical problem, we solve it. These are all riddhis. All these riddhis are operating from our energy centers below our eyes. Siddhis are a control over those riddhis, that you can siddh them. Siddh means to control them, make them within your own volition. So when you control these energies, then you get the power of siddhi. So siddhi powers are used by the energies below. They do not employ your awareness. In fact, if you use your siddhis, you move yourself away from awareness. And therefore, people who are disciples of perfect living masters, who've been taught not to go below the eyes in their meditation, when they employ siddhis, they lose the other benefits of meditation. So the advice is, don't go after siddhis and riddhis. Use the siddhi of the master instead. Somebody asked me, why don't you have proper white hair? I said, why should I have? Master should have. Right? Fair enough. White hair, if it comes by worry, he should have it. Why should I have? If the siddhis have to be used, why should I use a siddhi? Let him use it. So that's the surrender, that when you really feel that the master is within you and working within you, and you leave things to the master to do it, you will, like an automaton, like a robot, perform the functions. People will think you are doing it, and you will know master is doing it. No siddhis are needed for that.